There has to be more to life than just solving immeasurable problems. I represent the billions of people in the world who has no choice but to face the ongoing, never-ending survival game. Hardly any money in the bank account, and even if you manage to save a bit, emergencies happen, or you're self-deprived and in despair of the moment decide to splurge. And that way you just empty your bank account. It's that easy to lose money. Nobody wants to be around that person who might need their assistance, most especially needing their money. It's a terrible situation. The goal is to be a self-made person, that larger-than-life personality who dreams of something unimaginable, unreachable to many of us. A person who advances our civilization to achieve greater heights. That is the aspiration. Many of us do cling into the simple life, the farmer life, the ordinary but the beautiful life. However, to be reminded of the otherness, the madness of living in scarcity, and how that affects our relationships, that is something for most of us would rather prefer to remain a dirty little secret. Transparency doesn't have to be vocal. The media is a projection of the collective ideals. That is, in essence, the things we want to promote and plot into the public spaces. The absence of the mundane does the unity isn't noticed. It isn't felt. Only that these things are the things that we want to be visible, in the hopes that the next generation will learn more of what is good and what is bad or lucky in this world. We always have most of the population living in subsistence, in many levels, in many degrees, in many forms. That always has been the case since the dawn of mankind, the dawn of civilization. But for those who have, most aren't able to hold on to generational wealth, which is said to often culminate with the third generation. But the billions of us aren't looking for positions of power, but is searching for ways to define our lives, not by societal constructions of beliefs and forms, but a way to live life knowing that nature has already provided, that even if our birth parents have found it burdensome, that something greater has made room, has made space, has already embraced us in ways no human can. For those without economic interest to rely on, that we hopefully find a path in which we came to believe that in some God-level standards we are enough, that the billions and galaxies and stars meant that we are welcome in this universe. Even if we do live in a planet that seems too small or tiny for any of us to seem to matter. Easier said than done. We accept these good thoughts as ideals to live by. They remain ideals. We remain just as we are. The universe felt as empty as it has always been felt with the humans before us, our feet firmly planted in the ground, destined to fight interpersonal battles until our death, to repeat the same mistakes, and to not ever experience the much larger ocean than the one we can see indeed.